Hey guys, it's Dan, your host, Your Dan's Reviews, and today I'm back for another video. For today, this is going to be doing a very special video and our final video evolution for this year for the channel. This one is a very special one. This one I was very excited to do, and this is going to be the evolution from the beginning to where we are now of the showrunner community. There's a moment in your bones when the fire takes over. Blood is running, heart is pumping, as the battle gets closer. They can say what they want now, 'cause we'll be screaming out. We can be heroes everywhere we go. We can have okay guys, just gonna be doing another video for today. This one's gonna be doing another evolution video for today and our final evolution for this year, and for probably a good bit, because obviously, as you guys know, the evolution videos are coming to a close as of right now, as of this evolution video. The next time you guys will see a Saturday video from me, it'll be the Year of the Dead series, which I cannot wait to get into. So, this one I wanted to save for last, because this one is going to be a lot of fun. This one, we're going to talk about the showrunner community, which is a community that I am in, and I have been basically asked to go ahead and talk about from beginning to where we are now, what exactly went down in this community, how, you know, have we all formed together as a team, and not only that, talk about each core member of the community and how much they've evolved as, you know, just members of the community, basically. So, we are going to have, and this is, I think, the perfect time to announce in this video, we are going to have a showrunner community trailer, if you will, on the 31st of this month. It'll be a Dan's Reviews showing everything that's coming up in the showrunner community, you know, coming up that year. That'll be coming up at the very, very, very end of this year, legit, like the last day. So stay tuned for that. Good thing to announce in this video, I feel like, because if you guys are looking for that, that'll be on the 31st, and yeah, that should be a lot of fun. So let's talk about the showrunner community now from the beginning to end. So, okay, it basically all began in 2020. We had basically the first meeting between Matt and Cade, and basically, which are both Mega Matt and Wasteland World Official, that is, you know, what they go by, and essentially, they met up, and I remember Wasteland World was talking to Mega Matt about, you know, obviously, you know, helping them do a series, which was Wasteland World. So Wasteland World is a show that kind of was one of the jump starters of the community right there. As I remember, the two of them started to kind of work on that together. And it was a really interesting time, I remember, because, well, I wasn't quite in the community yet, but I remember it was starting to be kind of forming. And I remember I would, you know, kind of hear about this show called Wasteland World. And if you guys don't remember, I actually covered the show very, very first day. And I've, you know, been covering it ever since. But that's one of the big first shows of the community that really started things. And we still have been working on that now. And, well, I'll just say, guys, to kind of, you know, I guess, make, if you guys are wondering, the fourth season is under production. It is being worked on right now, so you can expect that at some point. But I'll just say this, that show is one thing that really kicked off the community in a really big way, and I thought it was really, really cool to kind of see things kind of, you know, begin there. But essentially throughout the rest of that year, you know, you had obviously the introduction of Mickey. Obviously he was there. You had a few other people that, you know, kind of tagged along, obviously, throughout that time. And obviously we kind of, you know, over time kind of formed the community. So that was, you know, 2020, the beginning of that, the filming of Wasteland World, the beginning of Road Rats, at least a little bit. I remember that back then. And we had, you know, a really cool beginning, I'd say, with both the three, Matt, Cade, and Mick, right? So those were the first three. Now, early 2021, this is when your boy came in, right? So, okay, this is when, obviously, I joined the community. We had, obviously, a, you know, a you know, great time. As soon as, of course, we all joined, we went as the core four. That's kind of what we started to go by with the four of us. Mega Matt, you know, Cade slash Voice on World Official, Mickey, and myself, Dan's Reviews. Now, obviously, once this happened, we had a lot of stuff coming out in the community. We had Survival of the Fittest Season 3. We had World Gone Mad having its very first debut on just in the community in general, and well, as a show in general. That was, you know, some really, really big stuff there with those two seasons. And, you know, obviously, WGM getting its kickoff early 2021, that was really big. And honestly, feels like forever ago, but it was only early this year that that happened. So we had the first season of that. And then, of course, we also had Wasteland World Season 3, which aired around this time. We had, obviously, that season, which, you know, is still a huge season. I mean, we had, you know, obviously, well, spoiler warning, the death of Samson and a lot of, you know, big stuff there. We also had the Fear of the Walking Dead rewrites, which, obviously, that was, you know, going on around that time. And we had a lot of shows coming out around that time of that year. I remember, like, it was crazy. We also had 10 Sea of Walking Dead, and we had a lot of stuff going on. And then there was a little bit of a quiet time there around the summer. I do remember that. There was a little bit of a quiet time where there wasn't too much kind of going on there for a bit. After Fear Season 6 ended, there was kind of about a month or two there where there wasn't too much, you know, kind of going on. And then we got introduced to our fifth core member, which is Rowdy. So Rowdy was introduced in, well, mostly I'd say like July of this year. He joined the community and he was around for a good bit. And we, you know, obviously brought him on as our fifth core member. And I thought it was a great addition. Honestly, he has been an amazing addition. And he has, well, since then, we've had Humanity Season 2. We've had, obviously, a lot of, you know, stuff going on there. We had Blood Diamond, which was announced, which is still a coming series, by the way. I can't speak for it, but it is a coming series that's going to be coming at some point here. So definitely stay tuned for that. And, well, over time, he has been kicking ass with intros. Let's just put it that way. He has been kicking ass with intros, making, I swear to God, every 2 seconds I'm turning around, he's making some sort of edit or intro or something. So the guy works hard on those. So definitely, you know, great work on his part. He has done an amazing job on all of those. And well, WGM Season 3 already has all its intros within a week of the second season airing. This guy moves quick, and honestly, I really appreciate all the work he's done. So that's another one. But essentially, throughout the rest of the year, we had The Walking Dead 11A. We've had a lot of shows come out since then. The rest of Season 2 of World Gone Mad, we had that. We had Survival of the Fittest Season 4, which was another season that released. Filming for Wasteland Season 4 is still going on right now, but it is coming to you guys. And obviously, waiting on the rest of Humanity Season 2, which is going to be coming up to you guys really soon as well, too. And Blood Diamond announced. And we also had Road Rats this year, which was another series that I really was excited to kind of watch. And it was a unique idea, a unique spinoff made by Wasteland World Official. He did a spinoff on Survival of the Fittest. And I thought he did a really, really great job with it, honestly. And last but not least, we had This Sorrowful Life Season 2 that came in with a really strong second season there. So, and there, basically, here we are. You know, Fear's wrapped up, World Beyond's wrapped up, and we are now, you know, just kind of waiting for all of these great shows to, you know, return and to obviously come back in the new year. We obviously do have a confirmed date for Survival and World Gone Mad. That's going to be February 9th, and the others will be coming up as well, too. But we got a lot of shows coming up, definitely coming up here soon. So let's talk about each core member now, all right? So we've talked about the community, things that have generically, you know, gone on in the community, and obviously where we started and where we are now. And it's just crazy, a phone call between, you know, these two guys that never met each other before and, you know, never even barely knew each other, started off like that. And then, I mean, hell, look at us now. Like, we have five core members, and we have just all this stuff. It's insane. Honestly, it is insane. Okay, now let's talk about each core member. So we'll start off with Rowdy. So Rowdy, obviously, when he came into the community, had a lot of, you know, big stuff. Obviously, like I said, he worked on intros. He had a lot of stuff. But he started off as, you know, making intros and this and that. And then throughout then, he's had Humanity. He is also working on, you know, Blood Diamond. And as you guys know, he's also working on a kind of mini film with Mega Matt. So there is a lot of stuff there with him. So definitely the way he has evolved from, you know, kind of a guy that was just starting to do, you know, Fear intros, and now to see the quality of what he's done now and to see all the content he's, you know, working on, not only with, you know, obviously his shows, but with Matt as well, too. I think his evolution has been really, really cool so far. Now we also have Mickey. Mickey, when he got introduced, now, again, you guys are going to have to bear with me here a little bit, because I only met Mickey a few months of him joining in the community, but I do know this, is that he was a very, very good special effects guy for Wasteland World. That's one of the most impressive things I've seen him do, create some of these amazing skins and some of these amazing just visual, like, you know, outfits that you see in Wasteland World. It's honestly, it's amazing what he does. A lot of the reason why Wasteland World, you know, visually is so darn good is because of some of the work that he does just behind the scenes. It is phenomenal, and his acting is also just out of this world for Warper and for, well, hell, any character he plays. So he is very good when it comes to that, and the way he's evolved from then and now, you know, obviously still acting, still doing what he's doing, and you know, really being a great addition to this community. So definitely Mick is another great member of this community. And then let's talk about the two founders, right? So we got Mega Matt and we got Wasteland World Official. Now, these two guys are the founders. This is, you know, where it begins right here. Now Mega Matt, as you know, evolving in the community, I can't even begin to say, you know, obviously he's had Survival of the Fittest. This is before he even joined. And then, you know, obviously we've continued and he's had many seasons of that. Many seasons of, you know, The Sorrowful Life, and he's had, you know, Road Rats, which obviously he's been working on as well too, and you know, he's co-written Wasteland, and he's done a lot of great stuff. Hell, even did some like GTA specials for WGM, you know, back in the day, if you guys remember that. And yeah, he's done a lot of really great work. So I think the way he's evolved from just having one show, Survival, you know, just focusing on that one thing, and now to see how much he's branching out is absolutely insane. Absolutely amazing job on his part. And then Wasteland World Official, starting off, you know, with, you know, a Minecraft show, and he's, you know, trying to figure out exactly how he's going to do it, you know, because he, you know, obviously worked on, you know, these, you know, comics for years, you know, working on the book version of, you know, Wasteland World, which obviously is a major, major, you know, nostalgia for him. Obviously, he's worked on that for so long, and now he's had, you know, multiple seasons of this show with actors and, you know, music and effects and all this, you know, all this stuff. He's also been writing a lot of different projects recently, and, he's really done a lot to kind of, you know, be in this community, and I think he's done a really, really great job. And then finally, myself. So, you know, people are like, Dan, aren't you going to talk about yourself? Yeah, I will, but obviously I want to, you know, talk about my brothers here first. But to talk about myself and the community. So we've had a lot of really, really great stuff here. Obviously, for WGM, obviously that had its, you know, kickoff this year. And obviously we had rewrites, which actually began early last year as well, too, and that's spilled in all the way to coming up this year. So yes, rewrites has actually gone on longer than WGM, but yeah, so both of those have been around for a while. I'm obviously making three movies, which I've announced at the most recent Showrunner Community, you know, live. The Killer in the Making, which obviously is going to be a three-part story of the Viper, so we're going to see that. And obviously, I started as the reviewer. This is how I'd say my evolution goes. I started as the reviewer, you know, covering things, talking about the shows, and, you know, kind of, you know, coming in here as, you know, kind of the main reviewer of the community. And then I've gone from that to basically nowadays, you know, I still review, I still do all that stuff, but now I showrun, I write, I, you know, do edits, I do all this crazy stuff. And that is, you know, I would say how I kind of have evolved in the community, is that I've just branched out so much more from where I've started to, you know, where we are now at the end of 2021. So guys, all of these people in the core five mean the world to me. Honestly, I want to say a huge thank you to all of them for not only bringing me in, obviously, well, mostly thanks to Mega Matt and Wasteland World Official for, you know, allowing me to come into the community and be a part of it like I am. And not only that, I think it has been an amazing ride. And honestly, to every single one of these guys that I've mentioned, Mega Matt, Wasteland World Official, Mickey, and Rowdy, all of these guys mean the world to me. And if you're watching this, you know you do. And that is basically it for this video. So stay tuned, guys. We have a Showrunner Community trailer coming up at the very, very end of this year. So stay tuned for that, for all the exclusive content coming up for the Showrunner Community coming up next year. So anyway, guys, thank you guys for watching the video. Write your comments in the comment section below. And of course, guys, if you're new here, click the subscribe button so you don't miss some of my videos for The Walking Dead and the Showrunner Community. Follow Dance Walking V on Instagram, guys. And of course, subscribe to Mega Matt. Of course, subscribe to Wasteland World Official, Mickey, and also Rowdy to get all the amazing intros, shows, and writing tips you can basically get. You can get any of that stuff here. And well, even if you want to know how to make some dope Minecraft skins, go to my buddy Mickey. Honestly, he will teach you that as well too. We got a lot of great stuff here. So before this sounds like more of a commercial, let's end this video. So anyway, guys, I'll see you guys really soon for another video. Enjoy the rest of your day, guys, and peace out.